Hi everyone! You are going to improve your English after you watch this video. That is an example of a complex sentence using a future time clause. Welcome to Jen's Jyugyou. My name is Jen, and today I'm going to teach you how to talk about the future using time clauses. First, please take a look at these four sentences. I will eat dinner. He is going to get a good job. We will travel. He is going to study. These four sentences are great examples of sentences using the future tenses, will or be going to. However, even though these sentences are talking about future actions, we don't know when in the future these actions are going to happen. And this is when we can use something called a time clause. A clause is made up of a subject and a verb. So we have two types of clauses that we're going to be looking at. Your main clause. What is the main thing that you want to communicate? I will eat dinner is the main thing I want to communicate. But when am I going to eat dinner? We're going to have to add a time clause. So let's take a look at four examples of time clauses, which are called dependent clauses. When I get home, after he graduates, as soon as we save enough money, before you play soccer. These four dependent clauses have expressions telling you when the action is happening. However, they are dependent clauses because they are not a complete sentence. When I get home. When I get home what? You need to have more information to complete the sentence. That's why you will put your main clause, what is going to be happening in the future with your perfect subject and verb, together with the dependent clause to create a perfect sentence about what is going to happen when in the future. So let's combine these dependent clauses with the independent clauses that we just took a look at. When I get home, I will eat dinner. He is going to get a good job after he graduates. We will travel as soon as we save enough money. Before you play soccer, you are going to study. This is how we can put the main clauses together with the time clauses to create a complex, complete, wonderful sentence that tells us exactly what's going to happen when in the future. What I'd like to do now is take a look at three important rules that you will need to follow to create these sentences. Three grammar rules that you need to know. When we take a look at the four sentences that we just finished making, you will notice that the main clause in each case is written using the future tense, will or be going to. And the time clause, known as the dependent clause, is written in the simple present. So when we are creating sentences using future time clauses, it's very important to make sure that the main clause is written in the future, but the time clause is in the simple present. And because it's in the simple present, you need to make sure you also remember subject-verb agreement. When I get home, after he graduates, right? So if your subject is he, she, or it, make sure your verb has an S somewhere in it in the simple present. So rule number one, your main clause, the main action that you are focusing on, uses will or be going to. The time clause that explains when the action is happening needs to be written in the simple present. Let's make two more sentences so that you can see how this works. When I finish dinner, I will do the dishes. When I finish dinner is the time clause. The verb finish is in the simple present. I will do the dishes is written using the future tense because it's the main action that I'm focusing on. He's going to live with his parents until he gets married. In this case, until he gets married is the time clause. So the verb gets is in the simple present. And he's going to live with his parents is the future time clause written using be going to. Rule number two for creating future time clause sentences is that the time clause can go at the very beginning of the sentence or at the very end of the sentence, and it will not change the meaning of the sentence at all. When I finish dinner, I will do the dishes. I will do the dishes when I finish dinner. These two sentences have the exact same meaning. Rule number three is when you are writing your sentences with future time clauses, you need to be careful about where you use a comma and if you use a comma or not. If the time clause goes at the beginning of the sentence, then you need to put a comma after it. But if the time clause is at the end of the sentence, you don't need to use a comma at all. Until he gets married, he's going to live with his parents. He is going to live with his parents until he gets married. In the first sentence, I need to put a comma after the time clause. In the second sentence, because the time clause is at the end of the sentence, I do not need to use a comma. Now that you know the three grammar rules for creating future time clause sentences, I want to take a look at the three main types of time expressions that we will use with future time clauses. Three groups of expressions that you need to know how they work in order to help you make the best sentences possible. The first group of time expressions that we will use are time expressions that you should use when the action is happening before the other action. This group of words includes when, after, not until, and as soon as. When, after, not until, and as soon as are time expressions that will go with your time clause to introduce the action that is happening first. She's not going to have a baby until she gets married. Until she gets married, she's not going to have a baby. So in this sentence, it means that first she will get married and then she will have a baby. When I get home, I will eat dinner. First, I will get home. Then, I will eat dinner. He'll get a good job after he graduates. So after he graduates is the time clause, and it means that first he will graduate, then he will get a good job. You won't improve your English until you study more. So this means first you will study more, then you will improve your English. We will travel as soon as we save enough money. So first we need to save money, then we will travel. So the first group of words that I just introduced you to are words that you put at the beginning of your time clause to introduce the fact that that action has to happen first and then the other action will happen. Our second group of time expressions that will go at the beginning of your time clause are time expressions that are used to introduce the fact that that action will happen second. The three words that are in group number two are before, until, and by the time. Before, until, and by the time. These words at the beginning of your time clause will help to introduce the fact that the action that's in the time clause will happen second, and your main clause will be the action that happens first. Before this video ends, I will ask you to subscribe to my channel. I will ask you to subscribe to my channel before this video ends. So before this video ends is the time clause, and I will ask you to subscribe to my channel as the main clause, and it's going to happen first. The video will end after that. It'll end the second action. Before she applies for a job, she will research the company. So in this case, she's going to do the research first, then she's going to apply for the job. I will study Japanese until I improve. Until I improve, I will study Japanese. So this means that I will continue studying Japanese first, then I will improve. By the time I'm 35, I will travel to Europe. This means that first I will travel to Europe, then I will turn 35 years old. So the second category of words that we talked about just now are before, until, and by the time. If your time clause starts with one of these three time expressions, it means that it is the second action that is happening. And our third type of time clause that you can create is using the time expression of while. While. When you use the word while at the beginning of your time clause, it means that the two actions are happening at the same time. While I'm on vacation, I will eat a lot of food. I will eat a lot of food while I'm on vacation. So being on vacation and eating a lot of food are happening at the same time. While I study for my exams, I'm going to drink a lot of coffee. These two actions are happening at the same time. Studying for the exam and drinking lots of coffee happening at the same time together in the future. So the third way that you can use time clauses is with the word while to show that the two actions are happening together in the future. If you're interested in learning about the differences between will versus be going to, please check out a video I made about that over here. So today, you could learn three very important grammar rules for creating future time clauses, as well as learning three different groups of time expressions that go together with time clauses to create very specific meanings in your sentences. And now it's time for question of the day. Today's question is, please tell me about what you're going to be doing in the future. Please tell me about what you think will happen in the future using time clauses in your sentences. Let me know your answers in the comments below. Will you subscribe to my channel before you go? Before you go, will you give this video a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss any lessons? When the next Jen's Jyugyou video is uploaded, I will see you, right? Good luck with your English studies, everyone.